Hello everyone, in today's tutorial we'll see how to create this really cool frame collage effects that you can see in here using Adobe Photoshop. It's a very easy and simple thing to do in Photoshop, so if you follow along you will be able to create the same thing and use it for your own pictures. Alright, so let's get to it. Alright, so let's jump to Photoshop, and then I will go to File, New, and let's create a new document using, let's see, 3000 pixels for the width, and for the height I think I will put 3400 pixels, and for the resolution I will keep it 72 and RGB in the color mode and 8-bit, and I will press OK. Alright, so the first thing that we are going to do is to create a background. So for this I will use a solid color, so I will go to adjustment and I will choose solid color. And I don't want to be 100% black, so I'm gonna go to the brightness in here and I will put 10. And I will press OK. Oh wow, it's very similar to the background. So I will right click and I will choose custom for white. I think now it's better. Now we'll just delete this background, and I will delete this layer mask because I won't use it, and I will call this BG. Alright, next I want to actually put some images of the newspaper, so let's go ahead and open them, which is this one, so I will take it and open it directly to our document. Alright, let's just resize it, just like that. And I will one click on this check mark, and then I will right click and choose rasterize layer. Alright, now I will change the blending mode of this to overlay. Alright, next I will go ahead to my folder again, and this time I will open this dust png in here and open it directly again. Again I will resize it a little bit. Alright, and again I will right click and rasterize layer. Alright, for this I think I will maybe drop down the fade a little bit to around 70 or 60%. Alright, now we'll go and let's see, yeah, now I want to actually put a little bit of vignette on the background. So I will go again to adjustment, and this time I will go for gradient. And in the gradient in here I will open this. And as you can see, this color stop is already set to black, but in here it's transparent. So first I will one click on this color stop, and I will change it to white, 100% white. And then I will click on the color stop on top of it, and this is where you can change the opacity. So as you can see, now it's set to 0%, I will change it to 100%. And I will press OK. Alright, after that I will change the style to radial. And I want the black to be actually in the corner or in the edges. So to do this, I'm just gonna reverse it. And then I will change the scale to 150. Alright, so something like this, it's okay. And I will press OK. Next, I will change the blending mode of this to overlay. Well, let's see, soft light or overlay. Yeah, I will go with overlay. And then I'll put down the fade to 70% or 60%. And again, I will delete this gradient fill layer mask. Alright, now we are finished with the background. I mean, for the background, it depends on you. You can just make it a solid black if you want. But for me, I like this a little bit of news to be in the background. But I think I will just put down the opacity of the news a little bit to around 80%. Alright, so I'm going to group everything in here in a folder. So I'm going to select the BG in here, and then I'm gonna press shift on my keyboard, and I will click on top layer in here, and as you can see this will select everything, and then I'm gonna press Ctrl Command J, and this will group them, and then I will call this BG. Alright, next let's start with our frames. So this is our frame. I already have it for you guys to download if you want. But for the members, it will be an extra frames and extra background for the final PSD, just to let you know. Alright, so I will go and open this frame in this same document. As you can see, it's a little bit small, but it's okay. Alright, so now I will just resize it to maybe, yeah, let's start actually to decorate our frame collage in here, so something like that for the first frame. Alright, so let's keep it like this, and then I will right click and again rasterize layer. Alright, so in this frame, actually we want the picture to live inside this frame, and to do that we will just actually make a selection of this hole that we have in here. So to do that, we will make sure that we are selecting the frame, and then I will go to my magic wand tool in here, and I will one click, and as you can see, this will make a selection of our space in here. Alright, now I will create a new layer, and I will just fill this with black. So as you can see, I have the foreground color set to black, so I will just go and choose the paint bucket tool, or you can press alt backspace or delete or option delete, but for this I will just choose the paint bucket tool and one click like this, and this will fill it. And then I'm gonna press Ctrl D or Command D to deselect. Alright, now let's call this maybe fill. Alright, now I want to link these two layers together. So to do that, I'm gonna select the fill layer, and then I will select the frame layer too. So by pressing Ctrl Command, I can select this one too, and then I will right click and I will choose link layers, and this way I can just select one of these layers, and then I will press Ctrl T and it will move the other layer with it. It doesn't matter if I select this one, I can select the frame and then press Ctrl Command T, and as you can see, it will fill it like it's a one layer. Alright, now I will select the fill layer, and then I will create a new document on top of it, and I will call this image. And then I will right click and choose convert to smart object. Alright, now we need to paste our image that we want to use in here. So to do that, we can just double click on this smart object right in here, not in here, in here, or you can right click and choose edit content. Alright, so let's go ahead and open our image. So I will start with this one, so I'm gonna take it and open it in here. Alright, now let me resize it. So this is a portrait, so I'm gonna put it right in the center, like this. Alright, I think looks good, like this. And I will one click on this check mark. And again, I will rasterize the layer. And then I will close this, and I will make sure to press yes to save. Alright, now we have our image in here. As you can see, it filled the whole space because well, it's a smart object that it has the whole space. But for this, we're gonna actually create a clipping mask to the fill only. And to do that, you can press Alt or Option, and as you can see, when we do that and go between the two layers, the cursor will change to this down arrow. So I'm just gonna one click and this will clip it for this one, as you can see. Alright, so we are done with our first frame in here, and you know, if you want to resize it or transform it, you can just select one of these two and then press Ctrl Command T, and you can just put it wherever you want, just like that. Alright, I think I'm happy with this, somewhere in here, and I will one click on this check mark. Alright, now we're gonna group everything together, so I'm gonna select the image, the smart object image, and then I'm gonna press shift and select the frame, and this will select the three layers. And then I will press Ctrl or Command G, and this will group them, and I will call this frame 1. Now it's very straightforward and it's very easy. We're gonna just duplicate these frames groups in here as much as we want to fill our collage. Alright, so I'm gonna press Ctrl Command J and this would create a new copy of our group, and I would call this frame 2, and I would just move it. But as you can see, when I move it, it moved the same with the same image. So to avoid that, you can just open the group and select one of these two layers that you can see in here, and then press Ctrl or Command T, and now when I move it, you can see the picture, it moved with it, just like that. Alright, but actually let me make it a little bit bigger, somewhere around here, and I will press Enter. Alright, so I will do the same. I'm gonna create a new copy of this group by pressing Ctrl or Command J again, and then I will rename it to frame 3, and again I will open the group and I will select one of these two layers, and next I will press Ctrl or Command T, and as you can see, I can move it now and put it wherever I want. Can even make it bigger if you want. Alright, somewhere around here, I think it looks good. Alright, so I will keep doing that, and I will fast forward this, and I will see you in a little bit. Alright, so I think I'm happy with this for this tutorial, and of course if you want to resize everything, you can just select the 10th frame and then press Shift and select the first frame in here, and then press Ctrl or Command T, and you can just make everything smaller to be that's right in the center in here. Alright, and of course you can add as many frame as you want. Alright, so now we're gonna actually make a little bit of shadow, so these borders that you can see in here, they can be shown. So to do that, we can just add a shadow for only one frame, and then after that we can just paste it using the Alt or the Option method. Alright, so I'm gonna, in this frame 10 group, I will just double click on it in here, or you can just go to the FX icon and open the blending options. Alright, after that I will select the drop shadow in here, and I will keep use global light in here checked, and I will just, as you can see, this is the frame for the 10th frame in here. As you can see, the shadow is moving, so I will just move it just like that, and I will keep multiply as a blending mode in here, so I will make it around 50%, and it's okay, I will keep use global light in here, that's actually good. But for the distance, I will make it like 30 pixels, and the size I would put it like 20, like 30 or 28 pixels in here, something like that. Maybe I will put up the opacity to around 60%. Alright, I think I like that, and I will press OK. Alright, now as you can see, we already have the drop shadow in here added for the frame 10th frame. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna press Option or Alt on my keyboard, and I will one click on this FX icon in here that we have in the group, and I will just drag it to the other group like that, and I will keep doing the same for all the groups. Alright, as you can see, now we have all the shadows in here for the groups, they all have shadows, and it doesn't look that bad. Alright, so the last thing that we are going to do is to add a little bit of adjustment, and this is definitely up to you, you can do that or no, but for me, I will just add a little bit of levels. Maybe I will add a little bit in the red channel, just a little bit of artistic colors, just like that, and a little bit of the blue channel, not a lot, maybe somewhere like this. And then I will add a little bit of exposure. So in the offset in here, I will put it to 0.0042. And the gamma correction, I will make it 0.96. Just to give it this fade kind of look to it. All right, as you can see, now we have our effect. It was very easy to do, and the good thing about this, we can use it as a template, which means that this effect, actually we can apply it to another picture without having to repeat the whole process again. All right, so let's me show you how to do that. So I will open one of this group in here, and as you can see, we already have a smart object. So I'm just gonna double click on this smart object in here, and as you can see, it will open in a new tab. So now I can just go ahead and open a new image in here, and I can resize it, maybe something like this, and then I will close it, and again I will right click, rasterize layer, and I will close, and I will make sure to press yes to save everything, and I will wait for it to be updated. And as you can see, we have the same effect in here applied to another image, as you can see. And of course, for the background, you can choose whatever background you want, it's up to you. But I think it looks really nice. And let me just go back to the other image, and that will be all. So I hope that you enjoyed and you like this simple and quick tutorial, and it was a little bit helpful for you. If you try it, just let me know on Instagram or whatever, just tag me. And don't forget to subscribe and comment and like to let people know about this video. And have a nice day. Thank you for watching.